Welcome to the Swamps of Corsus, the Angry Space Marine version. When you randomize, you know, the adventure mode for Corsus, sometimes you'll get these obelisks. Their location is very randomized, I have to tell you, so it usually is in the second part of the map after you clear a dungeon, maybe. But that's the general rule. I only found this once or twice on the second part of the map, so yeah. Let's interact with it. Some people said they found this in the survival mode, but as you can see, it's an obelisk that has multiple uses, so this is the first time I'm using it. And the more you use it, the more it goes up there. So in a way, it's a multiple use, but you'll have to find it even more times. Now, what did I use to open that? The Cryptolith Sigil. So to get the Cryptolith Sigil, you just have to go to the Queen of Iskall and she'll give it to you automatically on adventure mode. If you play on campaign mode, you have to give the Guardian Heart to her and she'll give you the sigil. Otherwise, just find her in the normal, you know, adventure mode. And then you can even fight her if you want, but that's how you get it, the Cryptolith Sigil. This is the obelisk that spawns. And the first time you get a trait, the second time you get a trait, and I think the third time you get the armor. So you have to do this 3 times. Now let's go and find that trait, because we have a lot of skill points or trait points available. So let's make that to level 20 as well. Concentration, weapon, mod, duration. Oh. So that's 20% more weapon, mod, duration. That means, for example, a skill like the bullets or the flaming bullets. That's 18 seconds. I didn't know how much it lasted before, but taking a while, I guess it was probably 15 seconds or something like that. Also, some of the other mods are increased as well. So this lasts 72 seconds. It was 60 seconds before. So this is actually great for summons, but some skills will actually be a little worse than this. So the corrosion lasts 36 seconds, which is amazing because this is the next power up in your game. Also, look at the Mender's Aura, 24 seconds. That's amazing. 36 seconds. But to me, the skulls are the most impressive ones because 72 seconds is a really big improvement. Now, the Veil of the Black Tear. Maybe I should use this even more, because with this one, it's actually better with the... Yeah. So, I don't know, people get lucky, people get unlucky, depends on how you play the game. And this is the little thing that should have the armor if you unlock it. I didn't unlock it yet, but I'll post videos as soon as I unlock it. So this is the other side of the doors. So this is why it was a little harder to find it, because it has a very rare chance to spawn. I mean, I think it will spawn once every 10 map generation or something crazy like that. And it will be on this side of the wall. So no matter how much you play it, no matter how much you try it, you just will get unlucky. But the good thing is that you can see it sometimes from the distance. Also, people are saying they found this in the survival mode and it has a little... the mechanics are a little more different, but I can't confirm or deny it because I haven't played survival mode yet. But again, as soon as I find more stuff and more videos, I'll just let you know. Now, I just want to wander around a little bit because I want to see if there is something else here that is, I don't know, no fee worth of exploring or seeing. Sometimes the swamps have dead ends here, so that's what I don't really understand. So, this is not a graveyard swamp map, because I don't see any graves. so much potential for this great trait. I mean, until now we didn't have a lot of useful skills, because, you know, they lasted too... They didn't last a long time, so let's actually use that Veil of the Black Tear. And maybe I'll use some other mods, but remember, once I get all the gear and all the skills, I'll definitely do some more build videos, because this is a very rich DLC with items, skills and other secrets. I want to see how good this is with 12 seconds. I mean, the difference might not be so big for other people, but it's kind of like... It's kind of like the difference between life and death in this game. Come on, where are you guys? Also, if you have any ideas for some crazy builds, let me know, because I am actually interested in doing more build videos. Because I kind of finished most of the content right now, only the survival mode is left. Okay, so it's a little dungeon, okay, I understand. It's like a little arena. That was actually pretty nice, I have to play more with it. Maybe this can also be used in the Ishkal Queen fight in the first phase, I don't know. Okay, this is funny. So if you are fighting a lot of ranged minions, this will definitely be useful. Yeah, those 2 seconds really help out this mod. Yeah, minion generation in the swamps is broken as ever. Anyway, see you next time. Bye!